Hi, thanks for joining me. Today I'd like to bring up a topic that a lot of you may be hearing a lot about in the news or are concerned about nowadays. With companies getting hacked and data breaches happening on a daily basis, how do you know that you yourself are being protected? We all have these debit and credit cards which allow us to make contactless payments, but did you know that your personal information could actually be compromised without your knowledge? I'm going to demonstrate how this can be done. Now I'm going to use an app which allows me to read data off of these cards and show you how easy it is for somebody to do. So I have the app loaded. I'm going to zoom in here so that you can see. I'll start with this card first. So you can see the number there. With most of my other information there blotted out, obvious reasons of course. Just like that, very easy. So let's try another card here. We'll use this one, and as you can see, that's the information there, and as easy as swiping. As you can see, it has read this card. Now, this card reader app is meant for analysis purposes, so potentially if there's additional information that's available that the hackers have figured out, then they could grab that info too. So here's a list of all of the previous transactions that's stored on the card itself. So let's see what happens if you have a credit card in your wallet. Can this read through that? As you can see, it was very easy. Now, granted that this application is for analytical purposes and it is not meant to read from far distances, but any hacker out there or anyone with some knowledge can probably rig something up with one of the development boards out there, such as Raspberry Pi or Arduino, and create something that can read at a farther distance. So what can you do to protect yourself? There are several solutions out there, and I will quickly go over two of them here. The first one being buying a wallet that has capabilities of blocking RF. So in this case, I have a wallet here by Bastion, and it can block those kind of signals. How these wallets work is that internally they have a fabric that's made out of some sort of metallic mesh, and this blocks radio frequencies. And so these are woven into the wallet itself. Let's try this again with this wallet. And as you can see, it's not able to read the card. One thing to note is that you don't want any cheap wallets where only the outside is protected. You need it so that even between the cards, on this layer, there's also mesh between that. It'll protect the card even if the wallet is open. And the last solution that I have today, which I will show you, is something called Vault Card. And this is the package here. And what Vault Card does is it itself is a card that has RF capabilities. So it works similar to your credit cards or your debit cards that have that contactless payment. What it does is it acts like one of those contactless cards, and but instead of sending actual data, it provides scrambled data to confuse any kind of card reader out there. If the thief has a powerful RFID skimming system which can read cards from far distances, the Vault Card can actually send out a stronger signal. The Vault Card is also only 1.2 millimeters thick, so it's just slightly larger than a credit card or a debit card. And it doesn't need any batteries. It's self-powered, similar to all your contactless cards. So what I'm going to demonstrate next is the vault card in use. What I'm going to do is place the vault card underneath my credit card, similar to how it would be positioned in the wallet, and then try and read the card. As you can see, it's not able to read it. Now, if I remove the vault card, it should be able to read this credit card. And there you go, it has read it. Now, if I try this again, and one last time, but this time what I'll do is I will remove the vault card slightly, and as it starts to read, I will push the vault card back in, and you will see that it cannot read the card. And there you go. It's not able to read it. One thing that potential thieves could do is they can skim the data off these cards and actually copy it onto another blank card and start making purchases, or they can use this data that they've collected and make purchases online, or even sell your credit card information to somebody else that would be willing to do that. So there you go, a few ways to protect yourself and your personal data on your contactless payment cards using either vault card, an active solution, or some sort of RFID blocking wallet, which is a passive solution. If you found this video useful, please share it with your friends and family, and also subscribe. It will help support the channel.